you guys, and for me, it's just even better that I get to talk about something that I'm super passionate about and that I really, really love. So I'm going to talk to you about geographic farming. I grew up with my dad in real estate. He always was a geographic farmer, and that's what he's taught me, and that's what we do. So let me say this too. I'm going to talk super fast because I have that 7 minutes, so hopefully you can keep up. And I will say that I'm going to talk to you about why I think you should farm, and then I'll talk to you about the how of farming and how specifically we farm, which we do a little differently than your traditional geographic farmer. So why farm? I heard the statistic a little while ago from a top agent in the Valley that 90% of the top agents in the country are geographic farmers. That's pretty awesome. When you farm and once you get the systems in place and do it right, it becomes self-perpetuating, meaning that it runs like a machine. And if you have everything set up, it's fairly easy to farm once you get those systems in place. You can also work off of referrals and repeats, which is great. And when I say referrals, it's so fun to get a referral from someone that's never met me, never used me to sell their home, but simply because I farm in that area and they know I'm the expert. And so they'll tell their neighbors and their friends and family about me, which is really awesome. The other benefit, or some of the other benefits of why farming, you get instant credibility. In the community, I'm seen as an expert there. People say to me, I see your signs everywhere. I love what you guys do for the community. You get instant credibility. So when I go in for a listing appointment, it's rarely that I'm competing with someone else for that listing, which is kind of cool. You can also thrive in a shifted market. So we know that the markets are fluid. They're always changing. We hear lots of talks of shifts coming. And in that, when that happens, the community gets, sellers get insecure, they feel nervous. And so when you, when you're the neighborhood expert, they'll come to you because they know that you're tried and true and really good at what you do. Also, my phone rings. I don't have to worry about cold calling. I don't spend hours on the phone. People in my farms call me to sell their home, which is always awesome. And then one of my favorite reasons is I get to build my business by relationships. Meaning when I'm out there doing community events and networking with people in the community, I get to build relationships with them. And so it's super fun because as the time goes on and then when they are ready to sell their home, they get me and they call me. So I love that. Now I'm going to talk about the how of farming, specifically how we farm. So a lot of people, there's a lot of big farmers in the area and they try to come in and farm our areas too. So and all that they typically do is just market. They'll just send their postcard pieces. We do it a little bit differently. We do all of that. So the first thing, if you want to be a geographic farmer, is to pick an area to farm. I don't care how big of an area. You can do 500 homes. I started with 2,000. So pick an area to farm, and I would ask that your farm has at least a 10% turnover rate. People say as low as 7%. Some people say it has to have a 15% turnover rate. My recommendation is a 10% year-over-year turnover rate in that farm. You also want to look at it and say, who has market share in this area? Not because you can't farm there, even if there's someone that's dominating the area. I think it's important to know who your competition is. And on the flip side, if there isn't anyone that's dominating that area, even better for you because then you can be that person. The other thing that's super important is consistent marketing. And I have consistent bolded there because it's so important that you are consistent. Oftentimes, people will send out postcards and do the standard kind of stuff, and then they'll just give up and say, hey, I haven't gotten any phone calls, I don't see the return. And what they don't realize is that had they just stuck with it a little bit longer, right around the corner was their success, was their listing appointment, was their win. It's just like in anything that we do, the consistency is where the win is. So be consistent. I will tell you that we send out, we touch our farm every 3 weeks. We alternate between a door hanger and a postcard and then a quarterly newsletter. And I also will add this. It's not so important what's on your pieces, okay? You can really send out the same exact postcard all the time. What's important is that your branding is consistent, that it looks the same, and that when they see it, whether they're picking it off their door or picking it out of their junk mail, they see it, recognize your information, and then it's in the trash, okay? So that consistency in the branding is really important. The other thing that we do is we layer what we do. So pretty much everybody will do those things. So send a postcard, yes, send a postcard. Door knock, this is huge for us. So I will say door knock for any and every reason, open house, just listed, just sold, whatever you can think of, hey, I'm in the neighborhood, door knock. When you door knock, we always tell our team there's three kind of goals that we have with door knocking. our first goal is we want to get that appointment, right? We want to get the opportunity to sit down in front of them, have that listing appointment. If we can't get the appointment, our second goal is to build our relationship with them. We want to connect with them. We want to somehow be seen as a resource for them. And if we can't do those two things, so we can't get the appointment, we can't build our relationship, we want to at least build our reputation with them. So even if someone is shutting the door in your face, as long as you can give them your info, always leave something there, give them your info, and say who you are, you've touched them. And that right there builds your reputation. Even if they're like, oh my gosh, I'm so annoyed, this person just knocked me, they got to hear who you are. And believe it or not, they will. That will lend credibility to you. Open houses, we do open houses, we do them just like everybody else, but we kind of take it a step further. We have 50 open house signs that we put out. We really try to saturate the neighborhood. We do personalize your invited invitations that will go into an envelope that will be delivered to the neighbors. We want them to feel like they can come. And sometimes we've tried it where we've just done generic open house flyers versus the you're invited, and we get a ton more attendance with the you're invited. So we do fun things like cupcakes and cocktails, but it's nice because it opens up the door for people to come. I would say get involved. You need to get involved with the schools, with hopefully you have an elementary school in that neighborhood, that'd be ideal. Get involved with the HOA, who can sponsor activities. Whatever you can do to connect and support them is great. If there's not community events, then you should be the one planning them. Plan the egg hunts, plan the photos with Santa. People will love it. Like I said earlier, people will say to me, I love what you do for the community. I know who you are and I love what you do for the community. So that's that instant credibility. The last thing we do is the garage sales. Sorry, I'm running out of time. We have everybody sign up to have their address put on a map. We collect all of their information. The day of, we hand out garage sale maps. And then we visit everybody with donuts. No real estate related, just here's some donuts, hope it goes well, totally branded to us. And then we follow up with a card, and that's where we kind of hit it with the real estate side.
Question. You can raise your hand and try and speak loudly so others can hear, and then we will start the 3 minute. Are you ready? Do I have a first question?
Yes.
All right, in the back. Start, please.
What is your budget, like monthly budget for marketing?
I've been super proud of it. It's always been right around 15% to 20%. We've just now, because we've kind of beefed up our farms and added to it, we're right at the 30%. And that's everything. That's all of our expenses.
No more? Okay, back here.
Yes, this might be cheating, but can you just real quickly finalize what you're saying about the garage sales?
No, I mean, that was basically it. Just follow up with them. It's a great way to collect their information, right? Kind of a subtle way.
Sure.
And they love it.
So when you're door knocking, say for an open house, how many houses are you actually knocking?
A minimum of 100. We got a listing from somebody that just because we did a cupcakes and cocktail open house, so they loved that.
What software do you use to target the market?
What do you mean?
You said you were looking for 10% turnover.
Yes. We just manually go in and run the numbers.
All right, that's all we have. If you guys will put your hands together for Janine.